Okay, good afternoon. So today videos, tuturuan ko naman tayo how to convert vertex form of the parabola to the standard form and vice versa. Convert vertex form to standard form, then standard form of the parabola to the best vertex form naman. Okay, so bago natin yan, silipin muna natin kung ano ba yung mga formulas na to. The standard form of a parabola is equals to y is equals to ax squared plus bx plus c, where a, b, and c are real numbers, constant daw, ibig sabihin. Tapos, yung a hindi daw pwede maging 0. Okay, x and y are variables where x and y represent a point on a parabola. So, tayo, sir. So, next. How to convert vertex form to standard form? So we know that the vertex form of parabola is equals to y is equals to a multiplied by x minus x raised to the power of 2 plus k. To convert the vertex to standard form, una natin gagawin yung expand the square. So expand muna natin yung nandun, yung x minus x raised to the power of 2, kung ano man yung value na ibibigay. Then distribute natin yung a dun sa makukuha natin sagot. Then combine the like terms. So paano po yun ginagawa? So bigay po tayo ng example. Let us convert the equation y is equals to negative 3 x plus 1 is raised to the power of 2 negative 6 from vertex to standard using the above step natin kanina. So ito po yung equation natin, negative 3 multiplied by x plus 1 raised to the power of 2 minus 6. Yan po yung tinatawag natin vertex form. So, ngayon kailangan natin siyang gawin standard form. So, una na itong gagawin, expand daw natin yung x minus x raised to the power of 2. So, dito sa given, ang x minus x raised to 2 natin is yung x plus 1 raised to the power of 2. So, expand natin yan, magiging x plus 1 multiplied by x plus 1. Or simply as x squared plus 2x plus 1. So, minultiply natin si x times x is x squared. X times 1 is x. 1 times x is x. Then x plus x is 2x. And last one, 1 times 1 is 1. Okay, so nakagawa na natin. So, ang next step, distribute daw natin yung a. So, negative 3 times x squared will be negative 3x squared. Negative 3 times 2 is negative 6x. Then negative 3 times 1 is negative 3. Tapos copy lang natin yung natitira, yung negative 6. Okay, next, combine terms. Combine the like terms. So, negative 3x squared minus 6x, then negative 3 sa negative 6 will be negative 9. So, tandaan natin ang standard equation natin. This y is equals to ax squared plus by plus c. So, ito pwede na natin sabihin, ano siya? Ito na yung final answer natin. Okay, so next, how to convert standard form naman to vertex form? The equation of parabola can be expressed either standard or vector form. So, tignan natin, ax squared plus bx plus c in standard form. Then, yung vertex form naman natin is a is equals, y is equals to ax minus h raised to the power of 2 plus k. So, parehas na yung itsura nila pag in-wrap natin yung parabola using standard form, then using vertex form. So, next, standard to vertex form tayo, ha? Tandaan natin. In the vertex form, y is equals to a multiplied by x minus h raised to the power of 2 plus k. There is a whole square. So, ano yung whole square dyan? So, to convert the standard form to vertex form, we just need to complete the square. Let us learn how to complete this by using example. Example natin, convert the parabola form to standard to vertex form. So given is y is equals to negative 3x squared, negative 6x minus 9. So ito po yung standard. So gagawin natin siyang vertex. So paano yung gagawin? So yung given natin, negative 3x squared minus 6x minus 9. First, we should make sure that the coefficient of x squared is 1. So yun po na natin gagawin. Siguraduhin natin na itong ano nito, numerical coefficient niya is 1 lang. So ibubukod natin ngayon si negative 3. Okay, if the coefficient is not 1, we will place the number outside of a common factor. We will get, ito ha. So, yung negative 6x natin plus 9 is sino ano? A negative 9 is pinactor para lang matanggal si 3. Nilabas natin si 3. So, multiply by x squared plus 2x plus 3 kasi nga negative 3x squared times x or negative 3 times x squared will be negative 3x squared. The negative 3 multiplied by 2x will be negative 6x. The negative 3 times positive 3 will be negative 9. So, ibig sabihin, ito, saka ito is parehas lang. So, ang ginawa lang naman dito is pinactor para yung maging numerical coefficient ni x is 1. Okay, tinanggal muna natin siya doon. Pagkatapos, step 1 ulit, identify the coefficient of x. So, dun tayo naman sa susunod. Kanina dito, in-isolate natin yung number para maging 1 lang siya. So, next step naman ngayon, kailangan natin i-identify the coefficient of x. So, ang coefficient natin ng x natin dito is 2. So, ang completing square na procedure natin will be, kung ano man daw yung numerical value nito, kailangan natin i-divide sa 2. Then, yung magiging quotient, kailangan natin erase sa 2. So, kaya ang mangyayari dito, 2 divided by 2 is 1. Raised to the power of 2 is 1. So, ito po yung answer. Okay, so next step. Step 3, add and subtract the above number after the x terms in the expressions. So yung kaninang, di ba, 2 divided by 2 natin is 1 raised to the power of 2 is 1. So dadagdag na natin yon at ibabawas natin dun sa tinatawag natin expression. Pero wag muna natin isisimplify. 1 is added and 1 is subtracted. Kasi kakailanganin natin tumamaya yung first three term. Kaya hindi natin pwede i-perform kagad. Okay, so factorize the perfect square trinomial form by first three term using the suitable identity. Here we can use x squared plus 2xy plus y squared is equals to x plus y raised to the power of 2. So yung x plus y raised to the power of 2, ito daw yung katumbas niya. So dito ngayon, kung papansinin natin, x squared plus 2x, ito na siya x squared plus 2x plus kung ano man yung value ni y. So therefore, pwede nating sabihin na yung x squared plus 2x plus 1 is ito rin siya. So pinactor lang natin kapag ka x times x, x squared. X times 1, x. 1 times x, x. X plus x, 2x. Then 1 times 1 is 1. So ito din siya. So ito ngayon yung gagamitin natin. Okay, so next natin. The above expression from step 3 becomes, ayan. Pinalitan lang natin yung first three term natin dito. Okay, so ito yung nakuha natin sa factor nito. So ang gagawin na natin next will be simplify the last two numbers in the distributed outside the numbers. So negative 1 sa positive 3, so magiging positive 2. Thus, the above expression becomes x, no, ito na. Negative 3 times 2 is negative 6. So, dito meron pa tayong negative 3 times, ayan. So, this is the form AX, ano. Ito na yung A, si 3. So, X, ito si X. Negative H, ito si negative H. So, si positive K, ito naman si negative 6. So, kompleto na yung ating vertex. So, nakuha natin yung value na negative 1, negative 6. Kasi ang value ng natin dito is X plus 1 is equals to 0 natin to. So, magiging negative 1. So, dito naman, y is equal to negative 6. So, dyan po nagtatapos yung ating lesson. I hope may natutunan kayo.